Hello everybody, Brad Johnson here, and I'm coming at you here from Muat Park here on Salt Spring Island, my new home. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about the reservoir of all knowing is feeling. But firstly, before I get into the topic of this video, I'm going to be retiring my private sessions, so the private one-to-one sessions, the light circuitry attunements, and the spiral Akashic viewings. All of them are going to be retired effective May 1st of this year. So, for all my subscribers, if you haven't had a chance to check out any of those private sessions, now's the time to do it, as they're going to be around for a little over 3 more months, and then they're going to be retiring. And in its place is the New Earth Academy. So I'll be talking about that in the upcoming Facebook Live video. But anyways, I'm just going for a nice stroll here in the park. And it was just allowing me a time to reflect, to process about a very common question that again comes up through a lot of my sessions and events. And that is about not only feeling, but also looking into the simplicity of things. Now, it's very, very challenging, especially if you have a very analytical, reasonable mind. And when I first started, I had a very analytical, logical, rational mind. And now just being around this beautiful nature, it just helps you to connect more deeper to the roots of simplicity. And it's when you feel that you're going through a lot of changes, a lot of shifts, a lot of metamorphoses, that you begin to realize how powerful feeling is. And I've certainly had quite a few metamorphosizing shifts, as I know many of us have. But it's when you're able to tap into that moment of the feeling. And when you're able to tap into that moment of the feeling itself is a reservoir of all knowing. This is why feelings can never be described. Because to understand how to fully, accurately express a feeling is like trying to share every single aspect of knowing within the entire universe. You know, we can't do that. You know, language is a part of that aspect. Our aspect of expression, our minds, our rationality, our logic are all just properties and aspects within the degree to what we call feeling, right? The feeling is this incredible just sensation that contains singularity. And it's when we're able to move into singularity and feel this energy, the sensation of feeling, of course, even through emotion as well too, because all emotion is just stacked up feeling. It's like a stack of pancakes, right? And when we go through those emotional states, it's so powerful that if we had the ability to understand how to harness that emotion, we can basically increase our own postnatal chi. We can bring ourselves into a greater state of inner alchemy. But it's just through the simple things. It's just through the idea that for me, walking through this forest, being here among the Salt Springian people, Salt Springlings, I don't know what you call them, but around the Salt Spring people, there's just such a calmness, there's such a wave of beautiful, warm energy. And you have that feeling, and you tap into the feeling, and it's like the feeling can tell you all about the land. It can tell you all about the people. It can tell you all about this space, this environment. And this is what I'm learning to tap in a lot more. And some people will say, well, Brad, to access the Akashic Records, it really is just a simple technique to go into a meditative state and aligning to the focus of what I want to look at and then being able to rationally bring that information in. In a way, that's true. But what you'll discover about the Akashic Records is that it follows the science of the simple. It's all about the state of simplicity. So when I worked with the Akashic Records, and I've been working with it now for about 8 years, what I've discovered is the more that you just simplify things, the more that you just allow feeling to flow, you don't worry about intellect. Intellect just goes with the stream. It goes with the flow as it relates to the feeling reservoir. So if you want to know more about ancient Earth history, align it to a feeling. What part of ancient Earth history would you want to know about through the Akashic Records? If you want to know about your own family lineage, what feeling comes up in that way? Maybe it's a feeling of curiosity. Maybe it's a feeling of excitement. Maybe it's a feeling of joy. Maybe it's a feeling of uncertainty. Whatever it may be, you're interlocking together with that feeling. That is how the Akashic Records speaks to you the longest and the greatest, is when you're tapping into that reservoir of all-knowing, right? And that's how it is. It's really, I'm just going to descend down here. It's really just all about tapping into the simplicity of all things, right? If we want to try and bring an analytical mind, an intellectual mind into all of this, you know, one of the common psionic aspects to that is remote viewing. But remote viewing always leaves you with more questions than answers, because again, it's aligned to intellectualism. It's about going into a room that's sterile, sitting down at a wooden table, having a piece of paper and a pen, and then just writing things out as they come. And it's a powerful thing, but really, it's still just based upon intellectualism. And again, it'll leave you with more questions than answers. And I too have been doing remote viewing since 2009 as well. I'm just kind of pacing around the forest here. It's pouring rain while I'm talking here, so I'm just looking for some nice sheltered spots. And there's actually some people playing what's called disc golf here. It's quite interesting. But anyways, going back into the understanding of remote viewing is that it is an intellectualism. It doesn't really connect to together with emotions in that way. And because it doesn't connect together with emotions, there's going to be a limitation in regards to the intellectualism that you're able to receive through the Akashic Records or through the remote viewing, as they call it, the collective unconscious. So the stream to all knowing, the reservoir to all knowing, comes together with feeling. When I'm basically teaching people about psychic ability, when I'm teaching them about working with their intuition, especially men have it the most difficult, I would say. Women are far more ahead. And again, I'm not trying to say that to be stereotypical, but it's through my findings of working with thousands of people over the years, is that men have the ability to be just as psychic, to be just as intuitive as a woman, but they again have, so many of us have been bred into following the rational path, the logical path, the reasoning path, right? And of course, I don't really need to explain this, as it's already pretty well known. But again, it's more when you are able to soften the heart chakra, when you're able to open up the heart. This is what I would suggest to everybody. If you really want to dive deeply into psychic ability, there's a couple of steps that you want to do. One, soften yourself. Make an environment that's beautiful, that's peaceful, that you can go into without any particular form of distraction. Two, create a concentration anchor. Okay? Now, a concentration anchor, there's many different names in a lot of ancient meditative states, but it's just a point of focus, right? So if you're basically in nature, for example, and you're going into meditation, and you're just tuning into a distant sound, so maybe it's a bird that's chirping in the background, just focus on that bird chirping, right? And think of nothing else. If it's kind of a very cool day, right? If it's a little bit nippy out, then that's a great thing as well, too, is you're concentrating on the temperature that exists around you. And again, you're not focusing on any other distorted thoughts that are coming in. So you're basically just creating an anchor of concentration, an anchor of focus. And when you start doing that, just start to soften, right? Make your entire environment like this feathery, beautiful, soft space, and just let it go into yourself and just feel the heart chakra calming, right? Other people can use like internal systems like yoga, tai chi, qigong, right? This is all about just gently going into certain postures and feeling your energy, right? Or moving your body nice and gently, flowing with the energy, flowing with the chi. That, again, is very, very powerful. It brings you into that anchor point. But the key here is to being able to tap into the all-knowing reservoir of feeling is just to soften yourself and let everything go. Right? Don't have any attachments when you're feeling like you want to go into the Akasha, Like, you want to look into someone's energy field, and you're basically having all these expectations. That's going to slow you down, and that's going to create lag, right? So, nature, right here. One of the most beautiful places to be when it comes to developing your softness, developing your own inner reservoir of all knowing. So really, when we're tapping into feeling, just open. Be okay with feeling that sensation. Be okay with your emotions. Be okay with everything that is subtle, right? It is the subtle energy practice through feeling that connects us to that reservoir. And when we're in that feeling, something of joy, something of bliss, something of compassion, something of just that smooth flowing energy with no resistance behind it, that is your capability. That is your temple in being able to see this flowing reservoir of all knowing coming to you. And the greatest way of understanding all knowing is to not be knowing yourself, right? It's going back to that old saying, if you want to know everything, let everything go. That's the concept. That's the premise. Once we start to tap into the singularity of feeling, everything's available to us as long as we can remain empty to receive it. So thank you, everybody, for tuning into this video today. Again, I'm just happy to bring you along Salt Spring here and seeing this beautiful nature around me. It's just, it's intoxicating and wonderful. But I'll be doing some more videos very soon. So thank you so much. Take care of yourselves wherever you are in the world. And I'll speak to you again in another perspective of the now. Namaste. And may it be well with you. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in to New Earth Teachings YouTube channel. Please feel free to visit our website, newearthteachings.com. Private sessions, digital courses, blog, free media, and a lot more. Again, newearthteachings.com. Thank you so much. And I look forward to speaking to you again in the next video. Take care.